Hello and welcome back. Today, I'd like to get into our RDP SSH feature that ISL Lite has to offer, which enables you to connect to any unattended computer with ISL AlwaysOn installed via RDP or SSH. Okay, so for starters, go to the Computers tab and click the menu next to the computer in question. From the drop-down menu, you will see the Connect Via option. And here we have RDP or SSH connection listed as options. In this case, we already configured the ISL AlwaysOn and RDP settings on this remote computer. So click RDP connection, enter the computer access password, and enter the Windows account username and password, and click OK. We then get a dialog that shows us that we need to configure the certificate. Click Yes, and here we go. The remote desktop connection starts, and we can control an unattended computer via RDP. Okay, so how did we configure this? Let's find out. Close this connection and go back to the dashboard. Let's pick a computer and let's try to connect via RDP. We'll get a message that says remote computer does not support this type of connection. That means that we need to configure the ISL AlwaysOn settings on the remote computer. So let's do that right now. Click Connect as you normally would through ISL Lite. In order to enable RDP/SSH connections, follow the next steps. First, make sure that you're using ISL AlwaysOn 4.4 or newer. If you're not sure which version you're using, check the About section from the tray icon menu and update it from there. Okay, so we right-clicked on the ISL AlwaysOn tray icon. Now let's click Settings. Under Settings, go to the Advanced section and here we have the Allow Tunnel Connections checkbox under Tunnel Connections. As you can see above, we also have Use Default Server Settings checked. For cloud users, the default server setting for Allow Tunnel Connections is disabled by default. To enable it, uncheck Use Default Server Settings and check Allow Tunnel Connections. For server license users, you may choose the default server settings on your ISL Conference Proxy Administration or uncheck it manually in ISL AlwaysOn. Okay, so the next step is to open the remote desktop settings for remote computer. I'll just press the Windows key and find Remote Desktop Settings. In order to enable RDP, let's click on that. Okay, now click Select Users that can remotely access this PC, and click Add. Enter the Windows users or groups who can have access to this remote computer, and click OK. Okay, now let's connect via RDP. Close the ISL AlwaysOn session and go to the computer we just enabled the settings for. Click RDP Connections from the dropdown, type the access password, type in the Windows username and password, and click OK. Again, we get a dialog that shows us that we need to configure our certificate. You can do this by assigning a certificate to the remote desktop services and avoid this dialog. Click Yes, and here we go. The remote desktop connection starts, and we can now control the unattended computer via RDP. All right, so we just showed you how to configure the settings to connect via RDP to a remote computer. Before we finish, we have also one more cool thing to show you. Okay, so let's close the RDP session and go back to the dashboards. Connect normally to one of the computers, type the access password, click Connect. From the top toolbar, click the desktop sharing icon and go down to Connect Via and expand the menu. Here we have some additional features such as Create New Tunnel. Here we can define a new rule for the tunnel. We can create an RDP tunnel to the remote Windows computer or an SSH tunnel to Mac or Linux computer. If we select Raw, we have additional options and can play around with the code by ourselves. We can then define additional rules, such as open a particular program automatically when a tunnel is created, or define whether the tunnel closes when we close the program, and so on and so forth. For now, let's select RDP. Use the default port and type the IP addresses of the computer we would like to access and create a new tunnel. Once created, it'll try to connect. So, type the Windows username and password of the remote computer and click Yes to connect. So here we go. We are connected to a new computer inside the internal network via RDP. In other words, you can only have one computer with ISL AlwaysOn installed, and you can still connect to any other computers inside the internal network through an ISL AlwaysOn computer by using the RDP or SSH connection. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope this was useful. You can also find everything explained in the written versions in the manual under Connect via RDP section. It's time for me to go. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.